Good day, this is Mission Control Houston. Thank you for joining us for today's ISS update this Friday, November 4th. This week has been a busy week for the crew aboard. Aboard the International Space Station on Monday, Expedition 29 Commander Mike Fossum had worked with the Space Dynamically Responding Ultrasonic Matrix System, also known as Space Drums. It's a suite of hardware that uses sound waves to allow experiment samples to be processed without ever touching a container wall. This allows materials to be produced in a microgravity with an unparalleled quality of shape and composition. The goal is to develop advanced materials of a commercial quantity and quality and help improve manufacturing processes here on Earth. He had also spent time on the Earth Knowledge Acquired by Middle School Students, or EarthCam, experiment. EarthCam is an educational activity that allows middle school students to program a digital camera aboard the station to photograph a variety of geographical targets for study in the classroom. Photos are then made available online for viewing and study by participating schools around the world. Educators use the images for projects involving Earth science, geography, physics, and social science. Meanwhile, on Monday, flight engineer Satoshi Furukawa had collected and analyzed samples from the station's potable water system using the Total Organic Carbon Analyzer, or TOCA, which is necessary for checking drinking water quality. The total organic carbon is naturally present in the environment and by itself has no health effects, but it provides a medium for the formation of byproducts that may be harmful. Russian cosmonaut Sergei Volkov had updated antivirus software on the laptops in the station's Russian segment. He also took surface samples to ensure that no bacteria or harmful materials were forming. Tuesday, November 1st, the Expedition 29 crew of the International Space Station had wrapped up preparations for the arrival of an unpiloted Russian cargo ship, the ISS Progress 45. Commander Fossum had spent much of his day working with free-flying bowling ball-sized satellites known as Synchronized Position Hold Engage Reorient Experimental Satellites, or SPHERES. During this session, Fossum had attached a smartphone with a video camera to one of the satellites to assist the experiment's sponsors with the design of a teleoperation interface. Working in the station's VESTA service module, cosmonaut Sergei Volkov and Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency astronaut Satoshi Furukawa had conducted a test of the Kurs automated rendezvous system that would be used to guide the Progress 45 spacecraft to the Pier's docking compartment, its port of call for the next 3 months on Wednesday. The two flight engineers also reviewed the configuration for TORU, the Russian telerobotically operated rendezvous system, which the crew can use to monitor the docking or take control of the process if difficulties arise. Later, Volkov and Furukawa had set up and tested the video camera system that would provide a view of the docking as Progress 45 arrives with its 2.8 tons of food, fuel, and supplies for the crew. Volkov also had spent time on Tuesday with the typology experiment, which studies a crew member's psychophysical state during long-duration spaceflight, as well as the identification experiment, which examines the station's dynamic loads during events such as dockings and reboost. On Wednesday, a new Russian resupply craft arrived at the International Space Station at 6:41 a.m. Central Time. The ISS Progress 45 had docked to the Pier's docking compartment after a trip to the station that began Sunday from Baikonur Cosmodrome, Kazakhstan. The crew had opened the Progress hatches to begin the transfer of 1,653 pounds of propellant, 110 pounds of oxygen, 926 pounds of water, and 3,108 pounds of maintenance gear, spare parts, and experiment hardware. Once the station crew members have unloaded the cargo, Progress 45 will be filled with trash and station discards, then undocked from the station in late January. Following its departure, controllers in Mission Control Moscow will raise its orbit to 310 miles so they can deploy a microsatellite. Once that microsatellite is deployed, Progress 45 will then be deorbited for a destructive reentry into Earth's atmosphere. Also on Wednesday, while Volkov spent the majority of that day on Progress transfer activities, Fossum had continued some science and exercise activities along with Furukawa. The two astronauts also conducted an eye exam to measure their eye pressure. Fossum loaded new software and configured a laptop computer on a science rack in the Destiny laboratory. The commander took high-resolution photographs of space grown crystals as part of the binary colloidal alloy test experiment. The current version of the ongoing study called BCAT-6 may help manufacturers design new leading-edge materials with molecular precision at the nanoscale. Furukawa had assisted Volkov with docking activities at the start of Wednesday and gathered tools to deploy a router in the future for the station's computer network. He also conducted crew departure preparations with FOSSUM. The International Space Station also reached a milestone in space. It had been continuously inhabited for 11 years. Expedition 1 crew members Commander Bill Shepard and flight engineers Sergei Krylov and Yuri Gidzinko began their stay of 136 days aboard the station on November 2, 2000. Following Wednesday's arrival of the ISS Progress 45 cargo craft, the Expedition 29 crew members living and working aboard the International Space Station had spent some time unpacking some of its 2.8 tons of food, fuel, and supplies on Thursday. Commander Mike Fossum and flight engineers Satoshi Furukawa and Sergei Volkov also spent some time Thursday gathering and packing items for their return to Earth. The trio is scheduled to undock from the station in the Soyuz TMA-02M spacecraft on November 21st. Remaining aboard the station will be the Expedition 30 crew of Dan Burbank, Anton Shkaplerov, and Anatoly Ivanishin, who are currently scheduled to launch the orbiting complex aboard the Soyuz TMA-22 no earlier than November 13, beginning their stay on the station on November 16. In addition to his work with Progress 45, Volkov spent some time with the identification experiment, which examines the station's dynamic loads during events such as dockings and reboost. As part of an ongoing study to determine the effects of long-duration spaceflight on vision, Fossum and Furukawa had conducted an eye ultrasound SAM. The ultrasound equipment is part of the station's health maintenance system. Fossum had also worked on the station's water recovery system, conducting some routine maintenance, and later participated in an interview with the Houston Chronicle during an in-flight media event that was broadcast here on NASA television Thursday. And today, marking the end of the 21st week in space for the crew on board the International Space Station, just before the hour, Commander Mike Fossum had completed a camera checkout of the binary colloidal alloy experiment known as BCAT-6 that looks at advances in manufacturing materials on the nanoscale. Fossum stored samples from a human body science study known as sodium loading in microgravity that studies fluid and salt retention in the body during spaceflight. Those samples will be stored in the minus 80 degree laboratory freezer for later return and analysis. Flight engineer Satoshi Furukawa will stow away the colloid experiment hardware after its operations and will also begin an hour of his regularly scheduled 2 hours of physical fitness. Meanwhile, Sergei Volkov is transferring a few items from station to Soyuz for return to Earth in a couple weeks. Earlier this morning, it was the non-human crew member Robonaut 2 that took center stage, even if for a while on orbit. Commander Fossum with Furukawa worked to assemble the dexterous humanoid robot in the Destiny Laboratory. Fossum began his morning working with Robonaut to flex its movable parts for the second time on orbit. While the first test performed last month focused on arm joints, today's mobility test focused on the robot's hand use for the first time, as well as movement of its other joints. The goal of today's test was to acquire more data on tactile strength, range of motion of its arms, and the mechanics of its joints. About 3 hours into the testing, however, a sensor issue relative to the device's computer program for the neck joints halted the testing for the day and ended the session prematurely. Robonaut was powered off for the day at 6:34 a.m. Central Time. The testing will be picked up at a later date. During Robonaut 2's exercises on orbit, flight engineer Satoshi Furukawa had gathered and packed items on board for their return to Earth on November 21st. Meanwhile, flight engineer Sergei Volkov snapped photographs of the onboard Russian plant's experiment that studies the growth of wheat in space. He also had spent a few hours unpacking items from the Progress cargo supply ship that docked to the station earlier this week on Wednesday, November 2nd. Later today, it will be Commander Fossum and flight engineer Sergei Volkov's turn to gather and pack items in preparation of the crew's return to Earth on November 21st. In anticipation of the soon-to-arrive Soyuz carrying the Expedition 30 crew, Satoshi Furukawa will spend an hour reviewing Soyuz docking procedures. He'll also later relocate an Ethernet cable to the Destiny Laboratory. Sergei Volkov will perform his second half of his daily exercise before the crew participates in a tag-up conference with the space station flight director. The crew will then be scheduled to go to bed at 4:30 p.m. Central Time, closing its 21st week living and working in space. And that's a wrap of this week aboard the International Space Station. This is Mission Control Houston.